Epic has now launched their new FAB marketplace, and while it promises to unify how we all access 3D assets under one platform, it might not be as straightforward as it seems. In this video, we'll look at everything that happened with last week's launch, the opportunities FAB introduces for creators, some concerning changes we should all be aware of, and most importantly, the urgent actions you need to take before certain deadlines pass. And for those who stick around, I want to go beyond just what FAB appears to be on the surface to explore what it signals about Epic's vision for the future and what that might mean for us as creators, which I think could be more substantial than we might expect. But before we get into it, I'd first like to welcome you all to the channel. And for those of you new to Unreal and worldbuilding, or those of you who've been around for a while but have felt stuck in an endless cycle of tutorials, I'd like to invite you to enroll in the 3D art curriculum that I released for free earlier this year. It's essentially a complete program designed to save you thousands of hours and dollars on your path to becoming a 3D artist and world builder. After investing over 3 years and $25,000 in our own game art education, my partner and I created this curriculum to guide future students through that same learning path that we heavily invested in at top schools like Think Tank, Noman, and CGMA. But instead of countless hours lost in a sea of tutorials on YouTube or needing to spend tens of thousands of dollars enrolling in countless programs, courses, and tutorials like we did, this curriculum instead gives you a carefully curated learning plan of the best and free tutorials and courses from around the web that mirrors how we would go about learning 3D and world building if we were starting over today. The curriculum is completely free and you can join the hundreds of students who have already enrolled with the link I'll drop below in the description. So with that said, and speaking of ways to save money, let's go ahead and hop into the good, the bad, and the urgent things you need to know about Epic's recent launch of FAB. What we're looking at here is Epic's play at consolidating all of their creative marketplaces into one unified platform. If you're completely new to what Epic has been doing in the space, they've been quietly acquiring various platforms and communities over the past few years, from Quixel and their Megascans library to Sketchfab to ArtStation. And now they're bringing all of these marketplaces together under one roof called FAB. But what's interesting is that this isn't technically FAB's first appearance. It actually showed up in UEFN as early as last year, which I think tells us something about Epic's priorities that we'll get back to later in the video with that long-term vision that I mentioned. Okay, so let's first look at the good things that FAB is introducing, and that is the unification of assets for us world builders, which I think is generally a good thing. Now, there's something to be said for competition amongst marketplaces, but since Epic already owns these platforms, I think consolidating that experience into a single place will benefit both creators selling assets and devs and world builders using them. Creators will only need to worry about posting and managing their products in one place, where they can take advantage of FAB's pretty great 88-12 revenue split, and as world builders, you won't have to always track down which store you purchased a pack or asset from, which I don't know about you, but between all of these platforms, I'm always getting lost between accounts trying to remember whether I grabbed what I'm looking for on Sketchfab during an ArtStation event sale, or whether I picked it up as part of an Unreal Marketplace free asset drop each month, or maybe I bought it over on Gumroad or on Patreon or any other number of asset marketplaces. So while this won't solve all of those beyond the ones Epic owns, it will significantly simplify things for a few of at least the major ones. There are also some benefits of integrating these marketplaces, as Epic has the opportunity, the key word being opportunity, to integrate the best features from each platform. For example, Sketchfab assets previews are much more robust and allow you to see texture maps of models in a really useful way, which is something that wasn't possible on ArtStation or the Unreal Marketplace. So now all creators uploading to and using FAB will be able to get access to this tech. Unfortunately, while the simplification of discovery, asset management, and integrated features like the Sketchfab preview tech is welcomed, at launch, FAB has some indicators that maybe this release was a bit rushed on Epic's part, and I think they know it. When it comes to the drawbacks of this release, just looking at press releases, blog posts, and forum comments, nearly every component of this release is in a temporary state or has some sort of disclaimer that things are still being migrated and/or worked on. A few examples are that while the Unreal Marketplace and Sketchfab stores are now closed for business, ArtStation remains confusingly open. Further, the written reviews that we came to trust on the Unreal Marketplace are now gone, so it will now be impossible to contextualize the star rating that you see on products, which frankly at launch are a bit lackluster. Now, I want this section to be clear. I do think these things will get sorted out, but at the moment, navigating FAB is a bit underwhelming with the way they surface, sort, and showcase available assets. As someone who has used Unreal for a few years, it still took me something like 15 minutes to figure out how to get a Quixel rock into my scene using FAB, first managing to install the hidden plugin in Unreal, navigating FAB's UI to the Quixel profile, which was no easy feat, pushing that already claimed asset to my library, and then finding that rock in the plugin, which seems to have placed discovery at the forefront and your library tucked below it, without any sort of Quixel or Megascan subfolder to navigate to. It was a bit wonky to say the least. Let's compare workflows for a moment. In Quixel Bridge, you could navigate or search through a really intuitive system, grab what you need, and add it directly to your project. Done. With FAB, you're now looking at a multi-step process. Come into FAB, find the Quixel profile, browse the assets, download them, go to your plugin, scroll through them, then finally add them to your project. This allows for a much less iterative workflow, where before you could just constantly try out how different assets might look in the scene. And that's assuming you're even using Unreal. For artists using other engines or software like Blender or Cinema 4D, there is no more plugin even bridging Megascans and those packages together at all, so the Unreal workflow I just explained is as good as it gets right now. I won't get into it now for the sake of length on this video, but if you're interested, Cinema 4D artist Aaron Westwood does an excellent, more in-depth video on this functionality lapse and oversight from Epic, which essentially makes Megascans, especially for larger projects, which might have multiple artists or in case where you need to hand off to clients, nearly impossible to use workflow-wise in those other programs as soon as the Bridge plugin is sunset, which Epic promises is coming soon. Quite frankly, my take on this is that I think Epic was pressured to push out FAB before the end of the year, before the product was in a shippable state. And while they had already likely planned to move Megascans to FAB as now a paid product, with the hopes of encouraging more vendors to sell on their platform and more individual creators to, for example, use RealityScan to sell their own assets without having to compete against the incredible and free resource that Megascans was, I think the reason it is actually still free until the end of the year is to incentivize everyone to sign up for FAB as soon as possible to drive those early MAUs up and just overall to soften the blow of its current state at launch, which they're also trying to do by padding FAB with a few other time-sensitive goodies that they have in the store at the moment, which I think is a good segue to those urgent things you'll not want to miss out on now that FAB is live. Okay, so there's three things you're gonna wanna do right now that FAB is up. First, you'll wanna sign up for FAB and install their plugin, which is a bit tricky. So to sign up, all you have to do is go over to fab.com and create an account. If you're coming from an engine other than Unreal, or if you plan to use the assets in Blender or Cinema 4D, for example, it's as easy as finding assets you want and downloading them as individual files or zips, just like you would in any standard marketplace. If you are using Unreal Engine, in order to get those assets into your scenes, what you'll need to do is come back over to the Epic Launcher, go to Unreal Engine, Library, and then scroll down to what has been renamed as the FAB Library. Hit this little refresh icon for good measure, which syncs this back and forth with the site, and then scroll down until you find what is called the FAB UE plugin, which you can install to the most recent Unreal Engine versions. I already installed it to 5.5, but you can see here I can also add it to 5.4. Once you're inside of Unreal Engine, you can access that plugin much in the same way that you would before with Quixel Bridge here. You just come down to FAB and pop it open. The second thing you're going to want to do, and this is a big one, is to make sure to claim all of the Megascans library that has been migrated to FAB. Like I touched on before, the unfortunate situation is that for now we'll be split into a few different cams and workflows. All of the Megascans assets that you had purchased or downloaded in Quixel Bridge prior to FAB's launch last week, you can still use just like you always have with that plugin until it is sunset. However, going forward, most of Megascans will be paid for anyone who forgets to sign up for FAB right now, and claim all the assets for free before the end of the year, which fortunately they have made incredibly easy. All you have to do is go over to FAB's site, and on their homepage you'll find a banner here that lets you just with one click instantly claim all of Megascans. So do that right now before you forget, because once we reach the end of the year, that offer will be gone forever. If you did use that script that was going around after the announcement to mass claim all of the Bridge assets prior to the FAB launch, you might be thinking that was a waste of time, and while it is amazing that Epic made it so easy to do this on FAB with one click, if you did take the time to do that with Bridge, the good news is that you can keep using the assets in Bridge while everyone like myself who didn't do that are pretty much forced to immediately start using FAB from day one despite the lackluster plugin features, since we can't download new assets to bridge at this point. The third thing you'll want to do, which is a bit optional, but I think a pretty nice incentive that Epic decided to offer to help soften this launch, is an exchange deal they struck up for Adobe Painter and Modeler. All you have to do is either upload any kind of asset at all to sell in the marketplace, or make any purchase of an asset yourself for anything over $25, and you'll unlock 6 months of Substance Painter and Modeler for free, which I think is a pretty sweet offer. So if you are paying for Substance Painter, you could put that subscription on pause for the moment and upload any asset you have laying around for sale on the FAB marketplace, or grab anything that seems interesting over $25 and save 6 months on that subscription, so long as you don't need Substance Designer and mostly just use Painter. I think this is likely to be a big net positive for most people if you claim it while it's available. If you are having a hard time navigating around FAB's marketplace, I'll link a few of my favorite purchases from the original Unreal Engine marketplace, which have made their way over to FAB, in the description of this video, that are well worth picking up. Okay, so now that we've covered the launch, some of the upsides and downsides in the short term, I'd love to speculate for a few moments on what FAB signals about Epic's vision for the future. In the short term, yes, I think this transition is going to be bumpy. The sunset of Bridge, the eventual paywall for Megascans, the consolidation of marketplaces. It's a lot of change happening very quickly on some aspects, but also not quick enough on others. And while Epic's vision of a unified marketplace sounds great, the current implementation leaves some gaps that many of us rely on for our daily work. But looking at the long term, I actually believe this could be a positive change for our industry. Having a unified marketplace with better revenue sharing could mean more sustainable income for creators, which leads to better and easier access to assets for all of us. And if Epic can deliver on their promise of more seamless integration between that moment of needing an asset and being able to get one into your scene, it could both lead to more sales of assets and content for creators, while at the same time significantly streamlining the creative process for world building. I think what is interesting here is if we zoom out for a second and look at a few clues in combination. One, FAB first launched in UEFN, which for those who don't know is a more of a high-level, lightweight version, though still powerful version of Unreal, aimed at creating Fortnite experiences. Two, Discovery is placed at the top of the hierarchy in the FAB plugin, ahead of your current library. And three, FAB launched in an unfinished state, yes, but the most notable gaps it took a shortcut on are when it comes to the deeper integrations that working professionals have come to trust and rely on from Bridge. When you connect these dots, it becomes clear, at least to me, that FAB in combination with UEFN is Epic's strategic move toward a future focused on the experience creator. They're not just consolidating marketplaces, they're rebuilding how creators interact with assets from the ground up. And I think Epic sees FAB becoming something like an in-app purchase system for creators. Imagine you're building a scene, you realize you need a specific asset, and boom, you can find, purchase, and implement it without breaking your creative flow. The friction between needing something and having in your scene just disappears. Now, I know in-app purchases usually get a bad rap, but stick with me for a second, because if Epic can pull off this vision, I think this could actually lead to something really interesting for our industry. Instead of constantly reinventing the wheel, spending countless hours creating assets that are really just slight derivatives of things that already exist somewhere out there in the marketplace, we could focus more on what makes our work unique. We could build on top of what already exists, putting our energy into the actual experience and story we want to tell. This hits close to home for me personally because I didn't get into environment and game art just to create assets. I got into it because I wanted to tell stories and to create experiences that move people just like the ones that inspired me. And sure, right now I do earn an income creating assets as part of that pipeline, and I do genuinely enjoy the process, but at the end of the day, that's not what brought me here. And in a future where FAB is able to surface and provide one-click purchases to dozens of relevant assets, I still might need to create or collaborate with someone on a unique asset from scratch because it still needs that extra edge. But I think this more friction-free experience will lead more people to the realization that the goal isn't the asset, it isn't that you made every piece of your scene from scratch, it's what that asset enables you to create. I know this perspective might land differently depending on where you sit in the industry. Those who are passionate about the craft of asset creation might see this differently, and that's completely valid. In fact, if you are focused on asset creation, I think FAB's revenue split combined with what could be a much larger marketplace of creators with much less friction between wanting an asset and being able to buy yours provides an exciting opportunity. But either way, whether you're creating assets or using them to build experiences, I think I share Epic's vision of this future where this ecosystem becomes more sustainable for everyone involved. The catch is that for this vision to really work, Epic needs to address those oversights we talked about earlier. They need to rebuild that seamless integration that Bridge provided, especially for those working outside of Unreal. And most importantly, they need to make sure they're supporting all sides of this ecosystem. The casual creators using UEFN to create experiences, the more advanced users who relied on things like Bridge to integrate across softwares, and of course the asset creators filling the marketplace. If they can deliver on all these things while maintaining that creative flow and better revenue split, I could really see FAB fundamentally changing how we all create in the future. But I'd love to hear your thoughts on this, whether you share this perspective or whether you see it differently. Let me know in the comments below what you think about FAB and where you think this is all headed. If you found this video helpful and want to find your way back for more updates just like this, go ahead and drop a like on the video and hit subscribe so you don't miss future updates just like this.